Hey everybody, it's Ed the Old Tech Guy! My Nest video is doing awesome! It has surpassed all my other videos, and I wanted to bring you another video that would complement that one. Before I create a video that shows you how to install a Nest thermostat from both a very non-technical perspective, and then another video from a very detailed technical perspective, I thought it best to create a video on the top 11 things you should know before purchasing a smart thermostat. And we'll bring you that right after this. Okay, thanks for coming back. We're gonna go through some very basic yet important set of things that everybody can do. Even if you are technically inclined or not, these 11 things will help you on deciding if you should buy a smart thermostat. I just wanted to add that I'm making this video because so many people are returning their thermostats back to the store because they couldn't install them, or worse, they're getting stuck with them because they can't return them. They're out $300. All right, let's start. Number one, and very, very important, know your Wi-Fi situation. The Nest and other smart thermostats are useless without a good Wi-Fi router or Wi-Fi access. Make sure to stand exactly in front of your thermostat and see how many Wi-Fi bars you have active on the Wi-Fi icon. To test the speed between your device and your router, device meaning phone or tablet, use an application called Wi-Fi Analyzer. They have it for both iPhone and Android. There's also another app that I suggest. It's called Wi-Fi Sweet Spot. I was using this when that was the only thing available for iPhone, and it measures your network throughput. It's real easy to use. You just hit start and it starts testing your internet connection. You can also see your wireless access bar icon to see how strong your signal is. Now remember, you do this while you're standing in front of where your thermostat is or would be. Number two, make sure you have a good internet connection. I can't stress this enough. The Nest and other smart thermostats connect outside of your home, your home's local area network, so that you can control your thermostat while you're not home. If you have a low level DSL internet connection or low internet connection in general, it won't work well. You're going to have hiccups and issues, and that'll really ruin your experience with these smart devices. Even worse, the latency caused on your phone, on the application, when things start responding slowly because the internet is slow, It's not fun, guys. I can't tell you enough how horrible that is. No one likes it. So please, if you're gonna buy a smart thermostat or start getting into the smart home set of things, get yourself a good internet connection. Number three, know your home automation ecosystem. Yes, this is very important. It's always a good rule of thumb to keep your smart home equipment all in the same ecosystem. This helps guarantee ease of use. For instance, if you purchase a Nest thermostat, you want to buy a Google Home Hub. And if you're going to buy a smart doorbell, then you want to get the Nest Hello doorbell. While I know that Alexa or Amazon's products interface well with some of Google's, there are some devices that only work well with each other. I'll give you a perfect example. I have the Samsung Home Hub or the SmartThings Home Hub, and my experience with that controlling the Nest has been awful. My wife couldn't set it up. People who are not technical couldn't set it up. I had an extremely hard time. So if you have things that are in the Google ecosystem, stay in the Google ecosystem. If you're gonna get an Alexa from Amazon, then consider getting an Ecobee thermostat. Your apps will thank you for it, and it'll make your life a whole lot easier. Number four, identify your components. Find your thermostat, identify your condenser, identify your furnace, identify your humidifier, identify your dehumidifier, as well as any germ-killing lighting and any water pumps that your system uses. Here comes a pro tip, guys. As you identify each system, use your smartphone to take pictures in front of the device and then take a picture of the model and serial number. This will make it handy in case you need to run new wiring or in the event you have a major problem and have to call in for service, you will have pictures of your model numbers, serial numbers, and your devices. This will make your life very simple. Number five, know your wiring. Guys, we're getting into the tough stuff here, okay? But don't worry, it's not that hard. While this can get technical, but again, don't worry, we'll make it easy as possible for you. If you're not technical at all and don't want to dig in even a little bit, then simply remove the thermostat and take a picture of the wiring that is currently there. For those of you who want to dig in deeper and have a nerd niche, go ahead and trace out your wiring and write down how your system is wired. Even better, when you're done tracing your wires, make a diagram. Next time you have to repair your unit or you have somebody repair it, they're going to love you having a diagram just like this one. Things to note, as you go down this path, like most electrical disciplines, there is a wire color code that should be followed, but is sometimes ignored. Meaning, sometimes there are repairmen who don't want to run a new set of wires, so they'll use an existing wire no matter the color and just jumper it, or there'll be wires that are jumpered together and only certain colors left over, so they'll use that. And then, to make things just a little more tougher, some colors are interchangeable. So I've got a cable right here. And your primary colors, that you're going to use in a heating and cooling system in most forced air systems is red, yellow, white, green, and black or blue. Here's where things get kind of funny, right? The black or blue, they're interchangeable for your C wire. And that could get kind of interesting. For a two-stage system, your color code starts becoming very, very important because you'll start using colors in specific areas. And I'll put a diagram somewhere up here that I created for dual-stage forced air systems. They'll use all these wires and they take specific colors. Again, be careful because while there is a color code and you want to follow it to make your life easier, it doesn't mean you have to follow it. So instead of red being your 24 volt constant power, you could use your black. It doesn't matter as long as it matches end to end, right? From your thermostat end to your furnace end. It doesn't matter. But if you follow the color code, it's going to make your life easier. So Let me give you just a quick overview of the colors. Your red, like I said, is your 24 volt power constant on. And then there's usually one that's called RC, and this is jumpered to that one, okay? Depending on your system, so figure that out on your end. Yellow, your yellow wire here is to turn on cooling on most systems, and that's usually the color code for that. White is to turn on your heat. It's the signal that actuates the heat on, off, so on. That's white. Green is your fan control. So if you have a steam system like I do that requires a fan at specific times, green is very important to understand your fan, you know, how your fan is going to be controlled by the thermostat. Black and blue, as they are interchangeable, are for your common wire, which has a constant voltage used for devices like your thermostat to keep the light on the thermostat, to keep your Nest or smart thermostat going. It's also, you can also draw power from it to power your germ killing lighting, like your ultraviolet lighting, and things that use low voltage again, but need it to constantly be on. It's not to be mixed up with your Red. This is used to power your heating, cooling, and other devices on your furnace. Don't mix them up. Again, I'll put some diagrams up here so you can look at. But this is very specific to your system. Understand your wiring before you go down this path of tracing this all out and making yourself a good diagram like this. Just understand your wiring. It's not hard, guys. I'm telling you, I work with wires every day. This is not a lot of wires to figure out. You just got to take time and patience and search it all up. Number six, does your system need a relay to activate another device? Okay, so as I'm showing you here with my diagram, my system needed an extra relay, which is right here. I had to put it in between my humidifier and my furnace's motherboard or logic board. I had to put it in between there because you'll notice it goes from the humidifier to the relay to the thermostat, from the thermostat to the furnace board, okay? If I didn't have this relay, the Nest could not control my Honeywell humidifier. This, again, changes from system to system to system. And you'll notice that I had to have certain dip switches set up so that this relay and this setup would work. So make sure you find out if your system needs a relay before you buy a Nest to control your other devices. Or if you could go ahead and rewire your system differently so that you don't need a relay and your Nest will work. When you start getting down that path, if it's too deep for you, know if you need an electrician. And we're going to visit that again. Number seven, now that you've traced your wires, do you need to pull a new set of wires? Sometimes you'll only have, you know, four like this, right? Or two or three. And you want to control all these different devices with your Nest. Can you do it? So how many wires have you found behind your thermostat as you've gone down this path? Two, three, six, eight? This becomes very important as you decide on upgrading to a smart thermostat. Did you notice if you have a C wire? If you don't have a C wire, there are options. For instance, you can buy one of those transformers, those wall warts that can wire into your thermostat. They'll wire right in and they'll plug into the wall. But you'll have this big wall wart, right? This big transformer, and you're gonna have these wires on your wall. Are you okay with that? If you have four wires, you may need to find out if they're data wires. That's right. Some systems use wires to communicate with the thermostat to a separate logic board known as an interface board, like the Honeywell THM5421C Vision Pro, I think it's called. The board is really controlling the whole system, and it's using the wires as data wires. So it's using these, whatever wires and whatever colors. There's no longer a color code when you're using it for data. It will just send on-off signals to the board back and forth from your thermostat to tell the board what to do. Are we controlling the humidifier? Are we controlling this or that? And it's just using your thermostat to measure heat, the heat level in your house, the humidity level at your house, and it sends that as data packets, but data frames through these wires into this logic board. If all you have is these four wires and that's how your system was set up, you don't have a choice. You're probably gonna have to pull a brand new wire just like this one with lots of extra wires inside of it to accomplish what you want to do. And there's no getting around it. There's also some device that goes in between called the Honeywell wire saver that will only use four wires. If you only have four wires, you wire them into this box, and then that box wires, you know, has all the wires you need. It'll have the just like this, the W1, the W2, the C, the G, the RC, the R, just like this, that'll match your thermostat. Your Nest can't work with that. Don't try it. At this point, if running new wiring is too much, you may need to hire an electrician. So while you were tracing your equipment, I hope you were taking pictures and you were actually looking around to see it, how hard it would be to pull a new wire, because that's going to get really important. Can you pull your own wire? Sometimes it's really easy to do, sometimes it's not. If you find out that you have the four wires and you can't pull a new cable through because you have a finished basement or a finished attic and you can't get to those wires without destroying half your house to find these, then maybe a Nest isn't a good idea for you. Maybe you need to stay in the Honeywell or whatever device you have ecosystem and go find one of their smart systems that'll work with that logic board or wire saver. Okay. Number 8, be careful installing your Nest in the winter, or smart thermostat in the winter, or any thermostat in the winter for that matter. You could kill your condenser. You kill it by testing your unit or your air conditioning in the middle of winter. This causes the condenser to kick on, and as the condenser kicks on, it causes heat. And that heat develops condensation because outside it's cold, but inside it's hot, and it causes water in the lines. And then as you turn that off because you're done testing, it freezes and it could destroy your condenser. And your $300 thermostat now just cost you $1,000 to $2,000. Do not turn on your air conditioner in the middle of freezing weather. That is a well-known fact for guys that work in this industry. Don't turn it on. Wait till the spring. So you have to ask yourself, is this the best time for me to buy and install a Nest? Maybe I have to wait for fall or spring after freezing weather. Number 9, are you a stay-at-home mom? Do you work 80% of the time from home? Are you happy with your current thermostat being at 74 degrees and not moving it? Then you're not a good candidate for the Nest. Save your money, keep your thermostat, find one that looks pretty or the way you like it, keep it at 74 degrees all the time, and that's it. I know the Nest is very attractive, or smart thermostats are attractive with all the lighting and cool numbers and stuff that they do, but if you're at home all the time and it can't save you money, you're really buying it for show at that point. And if that's what you want to do, go for it, but really, I don't suggest it. Number 10, save big bucks, guys. Look for sales. Here in the Midwest, ComEd or Commonwealth Edison, the local power company here, has tons of saving efforts for saving energy, and they're actually selling the $300 third generation Nest learning thermostat for $150 plus rebates. Check for sales from your power company around the country. All right, we did it. Number 11, we got to it. Here it is. After you've done all these things, saved a lot of money, being careful to trace your wires, making sure it's not the middle of winter because you want to test your air conditioning with your thermostat, making sure that your wiring makes sense to you and you've made some diagrams and you've tested your Wi-Fi connectivity in front of your thermostat, here is the last thing you have to think about. What does the wall behind your thermostat look like today? Does it look like Swiss cheese? Do you need to fix the wall before you can affix your thermostat to the wall? Guys, if you're gonna fix the wall, remember that your thermostat's not gonna be plugged in while you're putting tape and mud on the wall and doing and painting and making it look pretty. You're not going to have a thermostat on there. So is now the time to buy a smart thermostat and do all that wall work? Is it winter? Is it the middle of summer? Do you have older ones? Do you have young ones in the house? You have to consider these things before just putting the thermostat up there. And before you tell me, I know that they sell that plastic cover that goes on the wall, and then your smart thermostat goes on it, and it covers the Swiss cheese mess in, or the holes or however ugly the wall looks behind it. Let's be honest. You did not buy the Nest thermostat to look like that. You want it to look beautiful on the wall, like a piece of art, like the way it was designed to look. And you want it to have wall and then the thermostat. That's what you want. But then you put that white big thing and you're proud of yourself because you did it yourself. But at the same time, that white ugly thing looks horrible. And then you have family come over and say, ew. So plan accordingly. Is now the time for you to buy that thermostat, or should you wait for warmer weather, fix your wall up, get it all perfect, then order your thermostat and pop it in? And you may not even know, you may need to put some wood there. Your wall may be trashed. I've installed some thermostats where the wall is trashed, and I had no choice but to make a bigger hole, put some wood, mud it all up. Took me a few days. And worst of all, this person wanted it done in the middle of winter. They froze. They didn't care. And I was sitting there saying, oh my gosh. So please make sure you think through this. All right, guys, that's it. Nice and simple. Those are the 11 things I want you to think of before you buy a smart thermostat or Nest. On my next video, I want to take you guys through a site survey. I get a few people that ask me to go and install them. They pay me money to do it. I'm going to take you guys through my process, through the 11 steps, very quickly, because I don't need the client wondering why I'm bringing camera equipment to their house. But I'll take you through my steps, okay? And you'll see that it comes in handy. All right, everybody. I really appreciate you joining the channel. If you're a subscriber, thank you. If you're not a subscriber, consider subscribing. We've got lots of content coming here all the time, and I think you'll like it. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. Everybody, thank you so much. Have a great one. This is Ed, the Old Tech Guy, signing off.